us was the single rider aspect. We wanted everybody to be in a single rider cart with players from all over the place. We wanted to make sure that you had your comfort level there. So we partnered up with Graham Easy Go, a local vendor here in town. They've been fabulous in helping us facilitate the single rider aspect, which with 51 golf courses, and I like to say 31 being used simultaneously, that's a cool number to throw out there. But when you think about the logistics of that, it makes it a tall challenge.
The distance to the pin is 352.6 yards.
To make sure that we can have everybody in their own cart.
He will talk about some of the good effects of that. I played the fastest round in world am history today. except that apparently the guys that went off 10 played faster than us. They played in 3 hours. So the old format, which I mean it's the only way you get 3,500 people around golf courses, we had shotgun starts. You're playing in threes, you're playing in fours. I mean, I think everybody's learned through this break that the single rider golf cart is faster than two people in a golf cart. And that the solution to the single rider golf cart, as long as someone like yourself is willing to organize it, is the actual carts we already have.
Right.
You know, those things are great, especially when there's like one of you. How much of an adjustment was it on your part and on the course's parts to go tee times instead of shotgun starts?
Well, the courses, most of them will love the tee time aspect. That's what they do every single day. It's just common sense when you think about it, and some of these things will stay in place. You know, I'm not sure what exactly those things will be. Hopefully, we obviously have the 19th hole back in future years, but the tee times is great for everybody. You get your own start hole. You start on 1 or 10. That's great. Obviously, pace of play will benefit being in threesomes and tee times this year. So who knows what the future holds as far as keeping some of those aspects in place, but the logistical side of it, the golf courses have been fabulous. They want us to be here. They want to host golfers. So it wasn't just, you know, getting golf carts at the facilities or changing the tee times. It's making sure that the golf courses were there and willing to help us operate the event, which hats off to all of the 51 host facilities. They've done a great job because it's, you know, we can tell people what to do and how to be safe, but they're the ones who at the end of the day are helping us operate this event. So shout out to every one of the 51 golf courses for helping us do it.
No doubt. I mean, they're in the hospitality business, and one thing about the hospitality business is it requires people to be hospitable too, you know, and thank God they're starting to come back. There had to be a few months in there for you guys down here where you're scratching your head saying, is this ever going to end?
Yeah, at times. You know, the golf rounds here locally were great. You know, people picking up the game. I played more golf this year than I ever have, thankfully, which is great. But I think once we're through this, eventually.
Hang on, I got a question. Have Golden and Charlie Reimer been playing a lot of golf?
Ready.
Very important.
I don't know. They don't invite me.
Is that right?
You want to play on Wednesday? I could use a partner.
I might be busy that
could
day.
Could be busy.
He's running the largest golf tournament in the world.
It runs itself. He has people.
He's got Jeff Monday.
I might take John up as a volunteer over in the will call booth. Maybe he can help out there. You did say before we started, anything you need.
Anything you
the
need?
Distance
yes,
to the pin is 79.5 yards.
I met Tim Tilma today up at Sandpiper Bay. He's the general manager and PGA professional. And to your point, thrilled that we're playing off of the tees. It also, in this COVID era, it didn't bring us all there at the same time. The putting green wasn't overwhelmed. The practice facilities weren't overwhelmed. We showed up gradually. We left gradually.
Ready.
It was much safer. It was much better. And Tim was thrilled. And that group up there, by the way, Sandpiper Bay, was in great shape.
Yeah, and those guys do a great job. And I think the indirect benefit of tee times is the ability to be personal. You know, some of the drawbacks sometimes when you deal with such large numbers,
the distance
is that
to the pin is 20 feet.
The personable aspect may go to the wayside. And with tee times, you know, it's easy to interact with each of the golfers as they come in to the golf shop and head out to their tee times. So that's a great plus for these golf courses to actually get to interact, talk to people, see where they're coming from, and learn a little bit about them.
Yeah, I think you're going to see Tim was actually checking our card to make sure there were 18 numbers and there were two signatures, things that you went through, John, in your life. You
the
do
distance
sleep,
to the pin is 20
feet.
No,
I screwed it up.
So, but yeah, we've all screwed it up too, but I mean, a lot of these guys are competing once or twice a year, and without that guy in a score, we didn't have a scoring area before. Everybody finished at the same time. It was chaos. a guiding hand like Tim and the other pros in the area, it was really nice for him to sit there and go over it and make sure that we didn't screw it up.
Yeah, and I don't know what you shot today, but I know that you didn't screw it up. I think I saw that you're in T31st in our pairs competition, which is not out of it by any means. I believe that's out of 189 teams.
Well, my partner shot one under par today.
Well, I wasn't going
to
mention
who
carried the load,
but his partner
yards. Shot 10 over par today.
His partner, who shall not be named.
Ready.
Who shall not be named. but, yeah, that was one great golf.
That's all right. As long as you enjoy the experience, I assume Sandpiper was a new golf course for you, and that's one of the things we like to tout is that with the sheer volume of the golf courses here, you know, how long you've been playing in this event, how many new courses are you getting every single time?
I've been coming to Myrtle Beach for 25 years. Never played Sandpiper.
The distance
Bay.
To the pin is 85.3 yards.
Burning Ridge, I've never played, and then Heathland at the Legends, I know I've played, but I couldn't tell you. So two of the four I've never played before.
And Brian won't make excuses for the 81 that other guy's partner shot today.
That other somebody.
But
ready.
What time did you pull into town
That's
last night?
That's not important.
I mean, he didn't.
Ready.
He left St. Augustine, Florida at 7 o'clock last night.
I got in at, it was one-ish. And then, you know, the funny thing was you guys are so hospitable here, Scott. If I'd had the TPC today, I might have just stayed down there because I get the farthest. I was 40 miles from John's house.
The distance to the pin
that's
is 17
where I played
feet.
Golf today. So, you know, one to the north, one to the south, two in the middle. That's generally the rotation. It's really nice. Unfortunately, I was starting in Florida, and I get the one to the north.
And wasn't it like the first tee time out, too?
And we were first off, which, by the way, that worked out great.
The distance to the pin is 17
hours.
Feet.
I come back here and rest up.
How long was your nap?
It was a good two. I think the alarm said 2 hours and 4 minutes from now.
I've never once heard of a World Am tournament round being held in 3.5 hours. I think last year we set a world record.
The distance
for
to the pin
world
is 5 feet and
in
7 inches.
August at highs of 75, and this year maybe we'll set a lightning speed record.
It'll be the fastest.
3.5 hours.
Definitely. It's going to be the fastest World Am ever. No question. Scott Tomasello, our guest, he is the tournament director for the PlayGolfMyrtleBeach.com World Amateur. You have other events the rest of the year. We're gushing about how well-run this one is, but you guys do a father-son event. We're going to have Chris Nowak on from PGA Hope coming up.
The distance to the pin is 197.2 yards.
All year long.
Yeah, so we operate about 10 events annually, and we're adding to them pretty much every year. When we first started this, we had probably 3 or 4 events in the early 2000s. Now we're at about 10 annually. And we're picking up a few collegiate events, making sure that we can have a place for some of the collegiate golfers that may be displaced. But most of our events are for handicapped regular golfers, just like you or I, or maybe not John. In the November, we've got an event. January, March, April, pretty much the whole year, we've got a time of year and a handicapped or non-handicapped event for you to play.
He has a handicap.
I have a handicap.
Oh, he does.
I do.
What is it?
He hates it.
Is it legitimate?
Oh yeah. And he hates it.
It's a plus one.
Okay.
And I'm pissed. I can't break 75.
Well, we've got a scratch flat. I'm wondering why you don't play in the World Am.
I'm not an Am.
There you go. I mean, problem solved.
How big a problem is that?
So we do have our just for fun division. I don't know if that's suitable for you, but you can be anybody. You can play in that event. That's suited for anybody who maybe wants to have a few beers on the golf course or...
Oh, no, I can do that with the scratch purse.
For me, it's all about the rake. I'm a gimme guy, so yeah. I can't play tournament golf because I'll do an accident and get disqualified.
John Rahm picked the ball up on Saturday, and he won the golf tournament.
He's just like
That's
you
good
were
point.
got a new event that I'm just seeing for the first time ever.
Go ahead.
The World Am Q School event.
So that is our rebranded event. It used to be called the March Championship. We've rebranded to Q School. It's kind of a playoff the World Am. So in March, we'll have a qualifier
the distance to
for
the
about
pin
250
is 69 feet.
Players to try to win their way to play in the World Am that following August.
Nice. Also, the Dustin Johnson's Junior Tournament has become very quickly one of the premier events on the AJGA.
Certainly, and Dustin's put a lot of time and effort into helping us run that event. We're very appreciative of his support and entrusting us with operating the event. And I want to say this will be the sixth year coming up, and the field is just every year getting more and more phenomenal. Some of the past champions that we've seen come through there are just
the distance to the pin is 16
top
feet.
Top collegians, Trent Phillips, Alexa Pano, you know, some of the big names in junior golf that
right.
are making their way through the college ranks. So we're really proud of where that event is going.
Any thought to putting together, this just came to me, there is a entire group of collegiate golfers
the distance to
who
the
don't
pin
have
is
tournaments
16
to play
feet.
In this fall because
ready.
They've never had a need for a tournament in the fall. Did anybody think about, hey, maybe we should put together a 144-player field and let them come shoot it out?
Have you been reading our blog lately?
No, I missed it.
So in June, that idea came to us in partnership with Golf Week. We ran an event at the Dye Club in June. It went great. We had a good time. We were all safe. And now we've just announced yesterday, great timing, that we are doing an event at Carolina National this end of September for collegiate and amateur athletes to kind of fill that void where maybe some players are displaced. So whether you know if you're playing or
the
you don't
distance
know if
to
you're
the
playing,
pin is 392.9 yards.
22nd at Carolina
ready.
National.
That's okay. Fabulous.
PlayGolfMyrtleBeach.com has a lot of those details. I don't think it has that detail.
It's brand new.
It's brand new. Just to get
we clearly yeah, need to do.
Apparently, I haven't been on the blog in the last 24
ready.
Hours.
I'm going to talk to our marketing guy. He must not be doing his job lately.
We were busy. He was driving. I was shooting 81. So how good is this for Kismet? These guys run the Monday after the Masters Celebrity Classic. Hootie
right.
the Blowfish, they've done it forever. You've been a part of that for a long, long time.
I stand on the first tee and pick on people.
The distance
like
to the pin is 158.7 yards.
This year, coming up, they have the short par 4 Fall Classic, which happens to start the Monday after the Masters. They moved the Masters. These guys still have a tournament the Monday after the Masters. You can't fool these guys.
So we're having a Masters viewing party. A satellite viewing party. We're going to have about 400 players dispersed across area restaurants having a satellite watch party. So that timing couldn't have worked out any better.
You may have one dispersed
ready
3 hours to the east of here, or to the west of here sitting at the golf
ready.
Course.
Yeah. We.
I don't know if I can.
Are you going to try to get here and play?
I don't know if I can pull that off at the end of that week, but man, I'd love to.
We would be happy to have you. And coincidentally, Master Sunday is now my birthday. It might be the best birthday I've ever had.
Oh, my goodness.
And since we're always working Monday after the Masters, which unfortunately
the distance to the pin
year,
is 34.6 yards.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I have not worked the Masters in some years past. And the viewing party at the House of Blues with the auction and all that going on is always
ready.
Very entertaining.
Oh, it's incredible. And the auctioneer shouting out 5 miles
ready.
A minute. And
yes.
John's over there bidding on things he can't afford. And
just standing next to John Davey. Let him buy it all.
Different John.
Right. That's nice. Scott Tomasello, well done. I actually didn't even get the app yet.
The distance to
the
pin is 18 feet.
Is there still an app for this year?
There is an app. So our website is obviously key, MyrtleBeachWorldAmateur.com. We also have an app, Myrtle Beach World Am. Check it out. It's got a blue icon. Scores are posted nightly. Follow along. Check out based on your age, your handicap, where you might have fallen in this flight this year. See if you think you could beat some of the guys and girls that are competing
ready.
This year.
Yes. All the flights. How many flights?
62 flights this year.
62 flights. If you're a left-handed 1.5 that's over 50, you're probably playing against only other left-handed 1.5s over 50.
Well, you got to pick on the lefties.
It's not quite that specific.
I think he knew I was left-handed.
I didn't know you were left-handed.
Only in writing.
You play golf right-handed?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Interesting. Throw a baseball?
The distance to the pin is 160 yards.
Okay.
Michael Breed can throw both hands.
I saw that he won a back-to-back game or back-to-back games in high school as a switch pitcher.
Yeah,
ready.
He's a switch pitcher.
Where did we just read that?
I don't know, but it was on Twitter for sure.
Okay. Well, here's how I found out because I didn't read that. I didn't have binoculars. One of the event probably 2015
ready.
PGA Championship Whistling Straits. I need binoculars, and it may have been the one before that. And I'm working with Breed, and so we go to a Walmart, middle of the night, Sheboygan, Wisconsin, and we're bored. I got binoculars. We're going
to the distance to the pin is 40 feet.
We pick up a football. We start throwing it in the aisle, and he notices that I'm left-handed. And so we're throwing the football back and forth. He's throwing perfect spirals. He notices that I'm left-handed. He's like, oh, lefty. So then all of a sudden, he starts throwing it left-handed. And then we got asked to stop throwing the football.
In a Walmart?
In a Walmart.
You got in trouble in a Walmart.
In the middle of the night with Michael Breed. But those spirals were perfect.
Of course.
His were better than mine. He's throwing it left. I thought he was making fun of me. It was great.
Yeah. So, the more I learn about that guy, the less I like him.
Scott Tomasello, we appreciate your time and all of your hospitality.
Thank you guys for coming out. We appreciate you being here.
Thank you. We can't wait for 2021 and the world's largest 19th hole to resume. It would be very loud in here 20 minutes after 6.
Ready.
On night one if things were happening.
Yes. Can't wait. We got to bring you back later in the week. I know you got stories to tell, and we want to hear them.
Okay. I'll keep a few in the hopper for you.
I want to know, before we let you go, on the handicap thing, I think you should kick players out who can't live up to theirs, too.
Wow. The distance to the pin is 61 feet.
You know, if you claim to be a 2 and shoot 90, you know, that's also – it's a different kind of – it's a stupid form of cheating.
The ever-popular vanity. Ready. Yeah, we see that a lot. We see that a lot. Maybe we'll have a – you know, the obvious question every day is, well, you adjusted my handicap down. How come you don't adjust it? Well, we don't do that. We don't go up with your handicap.
No, you brought the handicap. We're just going
to – The distance
to
the pin is 7 feet and 4 inches.
We don't let suits out here, sir. We just make them – we just make
Ready.
Them
Ready.
Nice. Scott Tomasello, well done. We appreciate your time.
Thanks, guys.
We'll take a break. We're coming back with more live from the site of the world's largest 19th hole. It's not happening this year, but it will happen again. It's Katrick and McGinnis on tap.
Golf's major championships can be heard right here on Sirius 208 and XM 92.
Soft-tastic, smooth-fisticated, calm-tacular. Sirius XM's Yacht Rock Radio, the Doobie Brothers.
The distance to the pin is 416.5 yards.
And more from the golden age of soft rock. Yacht Rock Radio, sailing the seas of smooth on Sirius XM Channel 70. And listen with Amazon Alexa,
Ready.
Google Assistant, or however you stream in the house.
Covering a presidential election is a sacred trust.
And we take it seriously. We never stop working to get you the information you need.
From the caucuses to the conventions to election night and beyond.
We're there for you, uncovering the stories that shape the race.
Tracking the candidates and the moments that matter most.
Because this election will decide
the
fate of our nation.
And the future of the world.
Democracy 2020. It's in your hands. Fox News. America is watching.
Let's talk about the next chapter in fantasy sports, StatHero. StatHero provides daily fantasy survivor pools with smaller entries and easier chances to win. And players are loving it. Here's why. Imagine playing a survivor pool that pays you out every time you advance. You beat StatHero, you advance, you get paid.
Ready.
It's that easy. And the contests keep going until there's only one survivor. Keep beating StatHero, keep getting paid. Download StatHero today on iOS. For more information, visit StatHero.com.
This story is called The Ugly Truth About Timeshare. If you think you've done your family a favor by buying a timeshare, you need my help. Hello, I'm Chuck McDowell, CEO and founder of Wesley Financial Group. 10 years ago, I started helping folks cancel their timeshare contracts, and in the process started what's now called the timeshare cancellation industry. Timeshare is the only thing that you can buy that you can't tell me how much it's going to cost or when it's going to end. When you buy a timeshare, you give them a blank check to fill out any amount they want for annual maintenance and assessment fees. Sound crazy?
The distance to the
crazy
is
thing
feet.
Is, this never ends.
Ready.
Stop the insanity today. Call my office now. I guarantee if we can't cancel your timeshare contract, you'll pay nothing.
Were you lied to when buying a timeshare and want out? Get the facts about
the
timeshare cancellation. Call
feet.
Wesley now for your free information kit. 800-897-4400. 800-897-4400. 800-897-4400.
All four of golf's major championships can be heard right here. Sirius XM PGA Tour Radio. Sirius 208 XM 92. And on your Sirius XM app.
Every day, PGA coaches across the country are helping golfers reach their goals.
First time picking up a club? Let's get started.
16 holes still giving you nightmares? Let's conquer it.
Want to bring a friend along? Let's learn together.
Let's focus on health.
On fun.
On nothing at all. Let's talk goals.
Let's try something new.
Let's keep it going.
Let's have some fun. Improve, connect, or
skate.
The
distance to the pin is 443.3 yards.
Find your PGA coach at pga.com/coach.
Ready.
Kate, you're going to get us on tap.
Who's doing that version of that song?
It's a good question.
The distance to the pin is 174 right. yards.
Kygo.
I don't know Kygo.
I love that song, the old Stevie Winwood song, and I think I like that version. Drink and dance with one hand free. I like it.
That was Whitney Houston. Okay, well, I mean, that's...
That's why I liked it.
That's all you had to say.
Ready.
Ready. Special thanks to Scott Tomasello. How about, we mentioned that in that interview, we hadn't talked about it this show. John Rahm wins the BMW Championship in the playoff over Dustin Johnson. They're 1-2 in the world. They're 1-2 FedEx Cup points. That was just a fantastic showdown. Rahm gets it done despite that
penalty. The distance
have
to the pin is 32 yards.
Like that. Fifth hole on Saturday, John Rahm hits the green, walks up onto the green, picks his ball up. Didn't put the coin down.
Yeah, just a little hemorrhage there. Lapse of concentration. And knew it immediately. I mean, that's the other thing, is that when you do something that stupid, you immediately know it. It's like the wrong words coming out of your mouth.
Yes.
And well, now what do you do? And, hey, guys, I screwed up, you know?
They have loosened up a lot of the
Ready.
Rules.
You're not allowed
that used to
do
get
that.
You on the, you know, on the dumb penalties, little chintzy things, especially things on the putting green. I mean, after Dustin Johnson and Oakmont, I mean, they really loosened things up. Some of those changes happened immediately, and then with the 2019 revision, they loosened them up even more. But you can't fix that.
No, you're not allowed to do that.
No, there's nothing they can.
The distance to the pin is 37 feet.
Penalty for that, he goes on and wins anyway.
Sure, that's awesome.
Ready
and good for him. That's. I thought it was a great tournament. I thought it was the best so far since the restart. I thought it was over. That's the
Ready.
Second time that we've had, you know, the guy make the bomb that didn't
Ready.
End up winning the golf tournament.
Yeah, and then get it capped. Yeah, you mentioned the Workday Charity Open where Justin Thomas made the long one, and then Colin Morikawa, the very next swing from a pretty considerable distance, also went in. And in this case, it was Dustin Johnson on 18 to force the playoff, and then John Rahm in the playoff on 18 from 66 feet.
That was crazy.
Yeah.
The putt can't go in.
No. And did you see there's an interview clip
Ready.
of Joaquin Niemann. Joaquin Niemann's doing a post-round interview when Dustin made his. So they had some honorary observers out there.
Right.
There were more people out there inside the rope, or not inside the ropes, but outside the ropes than we've seen since the restart. There was an audible
applause.
Yeah, it wasn't a roar. I don't want to call it a roar. I mean, it was 25, 30 people. But they made noise when Dustin made it, and it interrupted Neiman's interview. And he was like, did he make that? He actually knew exactly what it was.
That's awesome. I mean, he probably was standing there watching it on the monitor, waiting for them to come to him.
The distance to the pin is 384.7 yards.
The North Course goes up and borders Vollmer Road 2 and 3.
Ready.
And even Mark Wilson was telling us there's a nature trail that runs down the left-hand side of 4. So
Ready.
We're watching Tiger on Sunday morning, Tiger and Kuchar, and the crowd had found him. Now, they were outside the fence.
Right.
And the fence has ivy and stuff on it. But you could see little faces peeking through, and he'd hit the ball, and they were yelling and screaming. It was the
loudest. The distance to the pin is 103 yards.
It was so refreshing to hear.
I have not heard anything beyond the Tour Championship, other than the two majors that we have coming up. I have not heard the PGA Tour say anything now. I read an article last week about Phoenix where, because it takes 6 months to put the stadium around 16, they have told the sponsors, we're not going to be able to do that this year at 16
Ready.
And 17, which is a real shame. But that's just the way that it is. I've always wondered why we got the reason a year or two ago why they don't have a permanent structure at 16. And it had to do with taxes and
the distance
city
to the pin is 33.9 yards.
Makes sense. And so it takes them 6 months to put that up.
Ready.
And then 2 months to take it down, or 3 months to take it down. So that if you're that could actually be somebody's only job, is erecting that thing at 16 and then taking it down.
Doing all the contracting and subcontracting. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, so I believe.
I don't know about starting Sonoma.
The distance to the pin is 54 feet.
McGladrey said no, RSM, which stands for Really Still McGladrey. That's not what it actually stands for.
No, that is funny.
I believe we got it on a piecemeal situation, but it wasn't a blanket across the board fall announcement, but I think we're pretty close to that.
I'm going to reach out to Steve Gent, who's tournament director down there in Jackson,
Sanderson Farms,
and just see where they are. Are we having
the distance to the pin is 20 feet.
These events coming up.
Yeah. Ready.
I mean, the pro-am to me, and I'm about to upset all the tour players who've really enjoyed not having an obligation on Wednesday. That seems like the safest thing to resume. It's outdoors.
Yes. I think there have been some on the Corn Ferry. I think they've done a couple.
Right. Corn Ferry Tour just sent five players to the U.S. Open. We'll talk about that in a few minutes.
Yeah. And look, I know it's been different, but at some point, this goes not just for the PGA Tour. It goes for all sports and all of life. At some point,
the distance to the pin is 275.1 yards.
Yeah. The pro-ams are going to have to come back.
Now, yeah.
They don't have to come back next week, but somebody's got to pay for all this. I know a lot of people are having a good time. A lot of people aren't having a good time.
Right.
But eventually somebody's got to pay for this.
Ready.
We're going to take a break. Some folks have already paid for us to have the freedoms that we have. And those
Ready.
Are the folks that have given their time and their service, and some of them even given their lives in defense of this country. We celebrate that in this game at Patriot Golf Day. It's coming up this weekend. Folds of Honor Foundation, the PGA of America, has embraced it with PGA Hope. Chris Nowak from PGA Hope is going to join us next. It's
the distance to the pin is 77 feet.
We're back right after this.
This is Brian Katrick of Katrick & McGinnis on Tap, and you're listening to Sirius XM PGA Tour Radio on Sirius 208 and XM 92.
The Kentucky Derby is on Sirius XM.
The 146th running will be yet another untraditional sports tradition in 2020.
Ready.
And while the pageantry continues without fans, the excitement of the Derby will be on display with Tis the Law vying for the second jewel of the Triple Crown.
Tis the Law and Lenny Franco win the Belmont Stakes.
Hear the horse racing
the
radio network's
the
call
for
the Kentucky Derby. Saturday at 5:30 p.m. Eastern on Mad Dog Sports Radio Channel 82.
Indeed Ready. Knows a lot of small businesses took a hit recently and are busy trying to figure out plans for the future. So if you're hiring, it means finding the right people is more critical than ever before. Indeed will help you find the quality candidates you need while only
Ready.
Paying for what you need. Claim your $75 credit to get more quality candidates fast when you post your first job at Indeed.com/high impact. That's Indeed.com/high impact. Terms and conditions apply.
Hey, Dad, your prescription will be ready in just a minute. Hey, Dad, your laundry will be ready in just a minute. Dad, your lunch will be ready in just a minute.
Hey, honey, why don't you take a minute? When you help care for a loved one, you give them as much time as you can. But it's just as important to take time for yourself. AARP can help. Find free care guides to support you and your loved one
the
at aarp.org/caregiving. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
Honey, it's a beautiful day. Let's take the dogs to the park.
I don't know. My lower back is really hurting. Maybe tomorrow.
Again? You really need to try those new shoes that Ed and Tina got. He swears by them for his
Ready.
Back pain, and Tina says they work miracles for her arthritis pain.
Well,
Ready.
If they help Ed, I'll give them a try. What are they called?
Mighty Walk, from Gravity Defier.
Only Mighty Walk from Gravity Defier Medical Technology has the patented VersoShock sole, clinically proven to reduce foot, knee, ankle, and back pain up to 92%. Mighty Walk offers wide and extra wide widths and comes with our exclusive corrective fit insoles for comfort, alignment, and adjustability. Try them risk-free for 30 days, and if your feet still hurt, return them for a full refund. But keep the insoles, a $50 value, as our gift. Right now, enjoy a $30 savings from Gravity Defier and get free shipping. Just go to gdefy.com and use code radio. That's GDEFY.com, code radio.
The distance to the pin is 33 feet. Ready.
Case is going to get us on tap. Live from the World Am. Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. This thing wraps up. It's always played the week before Labor Day weekend, leading into Labor Day weekend.
The distance to the pin is 9 feet and 10 inches.
A great holiday, and it leads into something that they put Patriot Golf Day on there. And joining us right now to talk all about Patriot Golf Day and the Folds of Honor Foundation, also the PGA Hope movement, Chris Nowak.
The distance to the pin is 9 feet and 10 inches.
Member. We love him. Chris, welcome to the program. How are you?
Outstanding. Thank you very much for having me on. Great lead in about the Folds of Honor Patriot Golf Day, teaming up with PGA Hope. So look forward to discussing it with you.
Well, give folks a little bit of background who aren't familiar with it, if there are still folks who aren't familiar with it.
Sure. So PGA
the
Hope.
The distance to the pin is 121.7 yards.
Through to help them overcome their disability, whether it's PTSD, limb loss, spinal cord injury, and we do that using PGA professionals to teach the game that we specially train. And that's, you know, the foundation
Ready.
Of PGA of America. And then, as you all know, Folds of Honor and
Ready.
Colonel Dan Rooney and all the great work he's been doing over the last 13-plus years. So the two organizations decided to get together, a lot smarter than me. As we all know, Seth Waugh and Dan Rooney got together, and now Patriot Golf Day is going to support both great programs. We're going
the distance to the pin is 12 feet and 2 inches.
Hope. So it's going to be a win-win for everybody.
It certainly will. This Patriot Golf Day has exploded, but we are in the midst of some very odd times. Tell us how it's going to work this year.
Yeah, you know,
the distance to the pin is 12 feet and 2 inches.
We are dealing with some odd times.
Ready.
You know, we're still holding the event, Patriot Golf Day. I think we have over 300 clubs have signed up. We have a Folds of Honor has a fantastic app now where you can just go on and pledge money for the day or just donate or find a course around you that is doing Patriot Golf Day. But, you know, as you said, during these challenging times, we need to also remind everybody that they're able to have these challenging times and voice their opinion one way or another, because of great Americans who have paid the ultimate price, and that is that sacrifice for
the distance
country.
To the pin is 488.6 yards.
Doing this week.
Ready.
Chris Nowak, our guest from PGA Hope, talking about Patriot Golf Day and the Folds of Honor Foundation. You lost your leg. What? How do you do? How do you do on Monday? Are you going out? How
Ready.
Are you choosing to celebrate Patriot Golf Day?
Patriot
Ready.
Golf Day, I will be going out. I'll be playing with I'm down here at Cape May, New Jersey. I'm living down here now, so I'll be playing with a couple of veterans from the Coast Guard. And I'm just going to go out and just have a good day and hit the ball. You know, COVID's affected everything, so it's impacted my ability to travel right now. But definitely going to go out and play around with
the distance
veterans.
To the pin is 204 yards.
Obviously, this the PGA Hope the concept is desperately needed. How did you become a part of it? How did you get to where you are with this? And can you give us a story or two of some of the guys who have benefited from it?
Sure. I was working for the Department of Veterans Affairs,
Ready.
Running the Adaptive Sports Program, and was doing some work with Scott Kimmick on PGA of America's side. And
Ready.
Was the time to maybe switch gears and get more involved in the game of golf. I saw
Ready.
How much it's doing for veterans. I know how much it did for myself in my rehab process. And my favorite story up to this point I like to talk about is a veteran, Army veteran, spinal cord injury, Randy Shack down in the Dallas area. He got involved.
The distance
in
to the pin is 42 feet.
Saw the program advertised at the VA. She told him to go. He went the first two times and didn't even get out of his vehicle. Finally, the third day, he third week he shows up, gets out of his vehicle, gets in his chair, and goes over, and they have a solo rider that he can play golf from. So he finishes out the next 5 weeks, and on this eighth week, I go down, and I watch him play in the graduation, which we do with the graduation. We allow the veterans play nine holes.
The distance to the pin is 42
feet. And he sunk about a good 60-foot downhill breaking putt that actually made ESPN's top five for that day. You know, and it's just the, you know, the impact it just had on his life.
Ready.
And that story. And that's the impact it does have on our veterans is golf is life changing, as I'm sure your listeners know. So if we use that as a therapeutic tool, it's a win-win for our veteran population.
Our guest is Chris Nowak from PGA Hope. We're talking about Patriot
Ready.
Golf Day, the Folds of Honor Foundation. If you want to learn more about PGA Hope, you can you can learn everything you need to know over at pgareach.org. There are plenty of other things you can learn there. One thing I didn't know, Chris, and I met you years ago. We've talked a lot, and I thank you again for your service to our country. But I didn't realize that some of that service came on the ice as member of the U.S. National Amputee Hockey Team back
Come
in
on.
2000. You're a hockey player, Chris?
Yes, that's my love. But I can honestly tell you, I have not laced them up or played since the game.
The distance to the pin is 300 yards.
But Ready. Hockey is my love.
All right.
What position? Come on. Are you hitting people? Are you
the
enforcer?
He is in the corner.
I'll tell you a quick funny story. In the Hockey Hall of Fame, they inducted our team and the Canadian team up in Toronto. And on the score sheet, they had the score sheet. Who do you think had the first penalty that's on the score sheet for the game?
Ready.
Well, I got to know. All right. So you know, obviously, if hockey's your first love. Our hockey fans in the audience already get this. The non-hockey fans, just we're going to try to put this as gingerly as possible. But there are some elements of the game that are just more violent than others, and it's just part of the game. Is it part of the game on the National Amputee Hockey Team? I mean, do you have to back off sometimes, or do you just play it just the way you would normally play it?
We play just the way they normally do, and that was probably the biggest skill set I brought to the game. I'm not the quickest on my skates. Don't have the best shot, but
Ready.
I can let people know that I'm coming down the line. So that, you know.
And do they say, hey bro, back off? This is not the NHL.
Yeah. Nah, we played in the World Championships over in Russia. We played
The distance to the pin is 31 feet.
IHF. So it was a great time. We had some good times out there.
Oh, I mean, you need a guy, John, that's going to go into the corners. And it's Will. Yep. I'm going to show you something. Chris is going to already know what this looks like despite not seeing there. Right in here in this eyebrow, I went into the corner against one of the Borth brothers.
The distance to the pin is 7 feet and 3 inches.
The Borth brother did. It wasn't Don or Kevin. It was the
Ready.
Ugly Borth brother. I don't even remember his name. But he knows what he did. But I taped this up myself.
Well done.
But you know what? He got thrown out of the game. He didn't mess with my guys anymore. My job got done, Chris, and I'm sure we won, as far as anybody knows.
Good
and
stuff,
later dude. later on, he laced those same skates up as the mascot.
That's not funny. Stop. It's true.
It's
not funny.
The distance to the pin is 322.2 yards.
Mascot for the one Philadelphia's rolled out there with that gritty. So.
Ready.
our producer Tim Jones is a big Flyers fan. I didn't realize that I didn't. I don't know the Philadelphia mascot issue. It's not a good mascot.
Oh yeah. Oh. Oof.
Well,
look it up.
Okay, I'll look it up. You may remember there was a minor league, the IHL level, the Atlanta Knights had a mascot that one of the coaches came over into the grandstands and beat.
The distance
on
to the pin is 74 feet.
I took over for that guy. But that was the same costume. That guy got fired. Oh, okay. We're looking at your
Gritty looks like a Muppet.
Yeah, looks like a Muppet on some drugs.
Yeah, I believe he's like they let Doc from Back to the Future create a Muppet.
Yeah, yeah. I swear when that first thing came out, and I was like, someone's doing it just to see if people will believe
the
it.
Distance to the pin is 27 feet.
Chris Nowak, thank you again for your service to this country, your sacrifice. Thanks for being on the hockey team, too. That's awesome.
Yeah, no, thank you.
Ready.
Thanks. You know, again, I appreciate all you know doing out there and allowing me this opportunity to talk about Patriot Golf Day. And I know all your listeners are patriots. I know they're all great Americans, as everybody who plays the game of golf. So, you know, again, I appreciate the time and opportunity.
Yeah, that's fantastic. Chris, thank you. Patriot Golf Day is Monday. FoldsOfHonor.org will tell you all about it. PGAReach.org will tell you as well. Chris Nowak, thank you for the time.
Thank you.
You got it. That's Chris Nowak from PGA.
The distance to the pin is 369.5 yards.
Just remember this, folks.
Ready.
A veteran just called you a great American.
That's pretty good.
That's pretty good.
Callaway's relentless pursuit of innovation in iron design has established a completely new standard for distance and performance. It's why Callaway has been the number one irons in golf for five years in a row. And this year, they created an iron the world has never seen, Maverick. Callaway's first ever irons designed by artificial intelligence. Maverick irons feature a new flash face cup designed by AI. That means that every face on every iron has been uniquely engineered to completely maximize
the distance to the pin is 79.4 yards.
Of gravity to be precisely positioned throughout your set to give you optimal launch and control with every swing. Maverick irons are available standard, pro, and max models to fit nearly every type of player, and all Maverick irons come with the classic sound and feel you expect from the number one irons in golf. New distance is out there. It takes a Maverick to find it. Get new distance at CallawayGolf.com. Callaway, the number one irons in golf.
Hey, when we come back, can we tell folks who got in the U.S. Open this past week?
Because we can.
It could be Woo.
It's Katrick and McGinnis on tap live from the World Am, and we're back after this.
SiriusXM
PGA distance to the
Tour
pin
Radio
is 29
your
feet.
Home for the U.S. Open.
Go back to school with SiriusXM. Get a hot lunch with music, games, and the latest kids' books every day on Kids Place Live.
Really? Yes.
On Labor Day, Hoda Kotb hosts a back-to-school special with Jamie Lee Curtis and Kristen Bell, all about pandemic parenting on Today Show Radio.
We're going to laugh. We need it.
And Business Radio covers the changing landscape of
industry
and education on the business
feet.
Of schools reopening. And get the latest on the coronavirus on Doctor Radio to help your whole family have a safe school year. Go back to school with facts and fun on Sirius XM.
They say that what you're made of is ultimately what you stand for. That's why Kent Wool Socks are made in the USA of the finest all-natural merino wool, which stands for the ultimate in comfort and performance. And now, XM listeners can save 15%. Just go to KentWool.com and enter the code ONTAP. Kent Wool, all American comfort.
Calling all baseball fans, it's time to go inside the clubhouse with Managers at the Mic on MLB Network Radio. Hear the latest news and updates on your favorite teams with one-on-one interviews with top managers from around the league.
The device
it's inside
is not
access
connected.
You won't want to miss.
The
for the complete schedule, visit SiriusXM.com. It's Managers at the Mic, only on MLB Network Radio. Sirius 209, XM 89, brought to you in part by Dish. Tuned in to you. To learn more, call 1-844-CALL-DISH or go to dish.com.
Hi, I'm Mike, Dish Network Service Technician. People call me the Good News Guy. I install TV's most powerful DVR, a.k.a. the Hopper. It holds 2,000 hours. You want that whole season? Record it. Oh, that one too? Why not? This DVR holds a ridiculous amount of TV. That is some seriously good news.
Whatever your passion, record up to 2,000 hours with Dish. Tuned in to you. Recording hours vary. 2,000 hours based on SD programming. To learn more, dial 1-844-CALL-DISH.
Covering a presidential election is a sacred trust.
And we take it seriously. We never stop working to get you the information you need.
From the caucuses to the conventions to election night and beyond.
We're there for you, uncovering the stories that shape the race.
Tracking the candidates.
and the moments that
the
matter most.
To the
because
pin
this
is
election will decide the fate
yards.
Of our nation
and the future of the world.
Democracy 2020. It's in your hands. Fox News. America is watching.
If you missed the latest tournament broadcast on PGA Tour Radio, you're in luck.
Left to right breaker, dead, solid, perfect.
PGA Ready. Tour Replay, the post-round show with exclusive highlights and interviews from the coverage, Ready. Is available as a podcast. Just log on to pgatour.com/podcasts.
Cheesy crackers, this thing is getting interesting all of a sudden.
You can listen or download the podcasts there or access them via iTunes, TuneIn, and Stitcher. Just visit pgatour.com/podcasts.
The distance to the pin is 24 feet.
Oh my gosh! Woo-hoo-hoo! Oh my heavens! How do you like that?
We're back with the stunning conclusion of the program.
The distance to the pin is 24 feet.
I'll rewind things down here. Katrick and McGinnis on tap. Going to tell you about the U.S. Open field in just a minute. Coming up next, Dave Marr. Fitting room at 8 p.m. Eastern. Golf U coming up at 9 p.m. Eastern. But our friend Sam Harrop is at it again.
Indeed. And now somebody is helping him to monetize his creativity, and it's about time. And it's our friends from the Action Sports Network.
All right. So here's Sam Harrop.
The distance
with his latest
to the pin
offering.
Is 168.6 yards.
Here's the latest song from Sam Harrop.
DJ,
he's just a machine. When he turns it on, 11 shots, that's just room. Man, Matsuyama.
Nori's got the baby drama. The distance to the pin is 52 feet.
Bryson's just Bryson. Webb's weak off's looking shrewd. I think we all know. Sam Harrop, and that's all about the wagers.
It's about the wagers, and he said, come Monday, we'll forget about it, which would make perfect sense every other tournament of the year.
Except
this one ends on Monday.
Oh, I thought we mentioned this with him. I didn't understand all the words because the piano got too loud.
The distance to the pin is 437.4 yards.
Go check it out. You can find it. What'd you say? It's over at golfbet.com.
Golfbet.com. There's a link on his on his Twitter account.
Ready?
Because he puts the words up, and you can have the captioning on it.
Yes.
If you want to see it, I didn't. I mean, I know that was funny stuff, but I didn't get all that. We need to get him a microphone.
Well, or somebody just to mix his. We need to produce it.
We need to get over there and produce it.
Yeah, or get him over here.
So U.S. Open field is complete.
The distance to the pin is 127.9 yards.
Brandon Wu, one of five players from the Korn Ferry Tour, who has earned a spot due to their order of merit. He won the tour championship up there in Indiana last weekend, and that got him a spot along with Steven Yeager, Curtis Luck, Grayson Sigg, and Dan Ready. McCarthy. They join 11 players off the World Golf Rankings who are now in. That includes Kevin Streelman, Harris English, JT Poston, Joaquin Niemann got himself in this past week, Thomas Peters, Max Homa, Lanto Griffin.
The distance
Michael
to the pin is
Lorenzo
67
Vera,
feet.
Matthias Schwab, Alex Noren, and Matt Jones.
Ready.
There are five spots left.
Okay.
So it's not full. I'm sorry. We got 139 players. There's five spots left. And that category is the final five not otherwise exempt based on the final FedEx Cup points list.
And there's
the distance to the pin is 7 feet and 5 inches.
Maybe two more spots because Francesco Molinari has withdrawn.
Okay.
And Jun Gon Hwang from South Korea is unable to play. He's in, but he has entered the military over there to do
the
his 2-year
mandatory stint. The distance to the pin is 7 feet and 5 inches.
We're currently at 139. So there's, I guess you're right, five
spots left. So the only guy that can change his FedEx Cup point position is Sebastian Munoz, because he's the only one in the Tour Championship that wasn't in the U.S. Open.
So he's in.
He's in, which means that the next four, Brian Harman, Tyler Duncan, Mark Hubbard, and Danny Lee, those are the next four that weren't already in, they're in because nobody's going to